according to VBT, the orbitals which are involved in chemical bond known as localized orbitals. Generally, sigma bonded orbitals. Sigma bond formed orbitals are localized orbital. When a pi bond is formed, pi bonded orbitals are known as delocalized orbitals. So due to delocalization of atomic orbitals, the formed bond is pi bond, or due to localization of orbitals, the formed bond is what? Sigma bond. If extent of overlapping increases, greater the extent of overlapping of atomic orbitals, whichever bond is formed, such bond is stronger bond. If extent of overlapping of atomic orbitals increases, the formed bond is known as what? Stronger bond. Always in overlapping process, properly oriented atomic orbitals of different orbitals can overlap together. Maybe means what? A s orbital overlapped with p orbital, a p orbital is overlapped with another p orbital, which are properly oriented. Otherwise there is no orientation. Order of extent of overlapping is sp greater than pp greater than which one? Ss. Order of sigma bonding overlapping is pp overlapping sigma sp overlapping greater than ss overlapping greater than which one? Pp overlapping. So this overlapping we have to remember. So that is the reason why sigma bond is a stronger bond, pi bond is which one? Weaker bond. Okay, so these are the main postulates of which one? Valence bond theory. Valency electrons involved in bonding due to overlapping process. Which process? Overlapping process. If extent of overlapping increases, what happened? Strength of a chemical bond increases, or bond strength increases. The next one is, earlier we are discussed which type of overlapping? Positive overlapping of atomic orbitals. The next one is negative overlapping. Negative overlapping of atomic orbitals Number one is SP. Number one is what? SP. Now, this is S orbital with properly oriented axis. Then, here is plus. Then here is negative, then here is what? Positive. This is S, this is what? P. So, here positive, here is what? Negative, then positive. So this overlapping is known as what? Negative overlapping. Second one is PP overlapping. PP overlapping. This is one P orbital, here positive, negative. This is the, because the lobes are not properly oriented. The lobes of orbitals are what? Not properly oriented. So that is the reason why these are what? Negative overlapping. Plus, here is negative, here is which one? Positive. This is the internuclear axis. When involved in overlapping, so therefore here is positive and negative. This is negative, here is what? Positive. The next one is, this is PP, which one? Axial overlapping. PP which overlapping? Axial overlapping. Axial overlapping. The next one is PP lateral overlapping. PP lateral overlapping. PP lateral overlapping. Here positive, negative. Plus, this is one of the axes. Here is negative, here is what? Positive. Along the internuclear axis, the lobes are perpendicular. So therefore, here positive, here negative, here negative, here is what? Positive. So this type of overlappings are known as what? Negative overlapping. Which overlapping? Negative overlapping. Then zero overlapping. Zero overlapping. Zero overlapping. Improperly oriented atomic orbitals are involved in overlapping process. That type of overlapping is known as what? Zero overlapping. Okay, for example, S orbital is V-shaped, spherical shape. This is the internuclear axis like this. Plus, This is the p orbital is like this. The internuclear axis of this one is, here is minus, here is what, plus. This is the axis. But here is what, this is the axis. So that is the reason why these orbitals are not properly oriented to each other. So along the axis, these are combined like this. These are combined like this. It cannot give a chemical bond. It cannot give a chemical bond. Here is positive. This is positive. Here is what? Negative. Okay. The next one is here is positive, this is negative. This is like this. The orientation of the next orbital is like this. This is positive, here is what? Negative. Okay. Almost no overlapping. No overlapping. This type of overlapping is known as what? Zero overlapping. So this is the overlapping process. Next, sigma and pi bonds. Sigma and pi bonds. This is sigma bond. This is which bond? Pi bond. Difference between sigma bond and pi bond. Number one is linear overlapping. A sigma bond is always formed linear overlapping of atomic orbital. Here is lateral overlapping. Okay, a sigma bond is always formed due to linear overlapping of atomic orbital. A pi bond is always formed lateral overlapping of atomic orbitals. This is the first one. Second one is, it is a stronger bond due to linear combination. Overlapping is extended in this particular atomic orbitals, so that is the reason why this particular bond is what? Stronger. Strong bond. This particular bond is which one? Weak bond. This particular bond is known as what? Weak bond. Sigma bond determines, is an important point. Sigma bond determine shape. Sigma bond define or determine shape of molecule. shape of molecule. Pi bond is say it cannot decide the shape of the molecule or no role in shape of molecules. The next one is, it is a directional bond. This is which one? Directional bond, because it is a, it, this bond is always formed in a proper direction along the internuclear axis. Along the internuclear axis, atomic orbitals are overlapped to each other to form this particular bond. So that is the reason why this bond is which one? Directional bond. It is which one? Directional bond. The pi bond is always known as what? Non-directional bond. This bond is always known as what? Non-directional bond. Okay? It is localized. It is localized bond. Localized bond. These are what? It is a Delocalized bond. Okay, so these are the main differences between sigma bond and pi bond. Main difference between what? Sigma bond and pi bond.